What's up, guys? This is the Awesome Show. I am Zeo, and today we're bringing you another My Morphin Collection episode. This time we're looking at these Tamashii Buddy Power Ranger figures. So I have held on to these for definitely over a year, if not maybe 2 years. It's been quite a while. So I got these back at Toys R Us when Toys R Us was still around, and I assumed they would make, you know, a whole set of these. And so I was trying to hold on to them till I got, you know, all the Rangers and everything, hoping that that day would come. But then Toys R Us ended up closing down, and I've not seen these sold at any other stores, maybe online or something, possibly. But and store-wise, I've not seen them. So I'm like, I might as well just go ahead and do a review on these and get them out of the box and stuff so I can put them on shelves and everything. But in this set, we're going to just do them in order. So they start with 27 and go all the way to 31. And they are these Tamashii Buddies. Again, they're another Japanese-based toy and stuff. And my brother has these in the Dragon Ball Z characters and stuff. So it's pretty cool. We got Power Rangers made by Bandai. And then you can see here we've got what I assume to be Japanese writing of, like, Red Ranger and stuff is what I assume to be there. Not really sure if that's what it is or not. But in the set, we've got the Red Ranger and Pink Ranger. And so these are cool. They're little figures that come with stands and backgrounds and stuff that look pretty cool. But we're just going to go through all of them here. So we've got the Red Ranger and Pink Ranger. Then we've got Lord Zedd. So that was the first wave that they released. And so those are the first three I bought and have had the longest and been waiting to do this on. Then they eventually released two more of the Green Ranger and the Megazord. And so I was like, oh, they are continuing on with these. But then it's been like a year now since those were released, and then Toys R Us ended up closing. And so that's why I said I'm just kind of giving up on waiting on more and just going to go ahead and do these. Again, like I said, they're little figures. I'm pretty sure they don't move or anything. They're just like little statue figures. And they have cool little bases and backgrounds and stuff, and then they can stack up and everything. So we'll look at all that. But let's go ahead and get into these figures. And so here's the first one we're looking at. We're taking a look at the Red Ranger here. And again, these look really cool, and I like this. So here is the display, so where it's got the background and everything, as you can see there, with the Tyrannosaur power coin there in the background, which in the all red and the lightning and everything, which continues onto the ground, which again, that's just like it's just a piece of like cardboard that you slide into there. And then like this is also a piece of cardboard, but since they're standing on it, it helps hold it down. But this can, you know, still, like, if you hit it hard enough, will pop out and everything. But here's a look at the Red Ranger. So it's funny, like, they're doing little poses and stuff. Most of them are doing the same, but this just because of my brother having the Dragon Ball Z ones, that it looks like they're doing the Dragon Ball Z, like, powering up. I forget what they call it, though, but, like, when the Saiyans are powering up and stuff, you know, like, the over 9,000 type thing, that it looks like that's the stance they're doing. But as you see there, he's got the Tyrannosaur helmet on, of course, with the teeth and the eyes and everything, and the mask of the Red Ranger and everything. Just looks really nice. Again, they made the classic, so no power coin on the chest, which is the proper version. A lot of things do it just to add more detail into it, but no power coin on chest. Got the morpher there on the belt, the blade blaster there on the side, and of course he's doing that stance like I mentioned. And then he's got the diamond shaped reds on his beat, on his boots and his gloves there and everything. Just the classic look of the Red Ranger, which again, there's not much detail to go into on these. They're same Power Rangers we've seen every time. But the cool thing is just this whole little figure there that is a statue, doesn't move or anything. But it's got this, again, background design here on the bottom, and then it feeds into the background here with the power coin, which looks really nice. So as it's displayed, it looks super cool because, you know, it just fits along with it and everything. And then these, you can't stack them. I'm not going to do them because I don't like them the way they look stacked up. But you also have these things you can then, you know, like, stick up in the front here, and then you can take another one. So like this stuff here, how it has the holes in the bottom, can sit right on top, and you just take this back part off and sit in. So then they just stack right up, which is nice if you want to try and save space, which I probably should be. But I don't like the way it looks when they're stacked up. It's not like these whole bars in the front and everything. I just want it nice, clean, and open without it so looking like it does here. So that's it for the Red Ranger. And that leads into the Pink Ranger as our next one. Again, it's the classic Pink Ranger look here with the helmet on that I like and everything, with the pink on the front of the pterodactyl, as you can see there, with the eyes and everything, and then the white on the background there in the mouth, as you can see. And then it's in just in classic outfit. It's got the skirting on, morpher there on the chest, blade blaster, and then her hands are out to the side, which I like a little bit better because, like I said, it doesn't remind me as much as Dragon Ball Z. But you know, I assume, like, if there's females from Dragon Ball, they probably have that same pose as well going on. And then it's just, you know, same character of all pink and white and everything going on. Again, not much to look at with the characters, just the same old Rangers, everything, no movements or anything. But then we go into the backgrounds here of the pink with the lightning, and then the pink with lightning, and the Pteranodon power coin there in the background, which looks really nice. And when I first put this together, I accidentally put it in upside down. I was like, wait, that doesn't look right, so I had to switch it out. Again, there's not much to look at with these things. They're just nice little display figures, little like statue type things. So there's not a whole lot to look at, and like I said, they don't move or anything, so there's no poses you can do or anything like that. They're just kind of stuck there the way they are. And like I said, just mostly the overall look, they're just a nice little display figure to see, sit here and look at, you know, with the pink, with the coin in the background and stuff. It just looks super nice and everything. So that, I guess, will be it for the Pink Ranger. And next up is Lord Zedd, the evil Lord Zedd. And so this figure looks really cool. So I'll start off with looking at it. Of course, we've got his all metallic silver helmet going on here with like the whole mouthpiece, and then the red metallic visor there. And it's got this whole little beading around his head with the giant prong coming up with the Z on it for Zedd, of course. Then you can see the brain, which I like all the brain details. It looks really nice and cool, everything, seeing all the brains and stuff there. Then going into the body, where again, it's all muscled body, and then it has this exoskeleton of the silver parts here, as you can see, building a skeleton. And then the tubes, what I assume to be pumpy blood throughout him, and the blue version here, as you can see, going all the way around through him. And again, he's got the exoskeleton on, because I assume he's got like no spine or bones or anything inside. He's just a bunch of muscle, and what's holding him together is these silver bones and skeleton and stuff holding together and up, which looks really cool and is a neat idea for a bad guy and stuff. You can see his feet there, which look kind of funny. It looks like he's got weird little shoes on and stuff, but they look really cool at the same time. And then of course he's got his scepter here with the Z on it, of course, for Zedd and everything. The scepter here, and it goes down through his hand. It's got the nice big spike there on the bottom, and I thought it would move because we'll see later on one of the things you can take in and out of their hands, but it looks like it's kind of molded in there and everything. Then a look at the background. So on the bottom, he's got what looks like a brick floor, which does, you know, kind of remind me of what looks like Rita's palace or whatever, like the floor of that. So that's kind of cool, and it's got like the foggy red going on to it. Then in the background, you can see the giant Z for Zedd, and it's again got some of this foggy look to it, and then lightning as well continuing on, and it's all red. So it's very similar to the Red Ranger, but I like the whole fogginess they added to it, because if you remember in Rita's castle, there's always a lot of fog going on in the ground and stuff, a lot of whatever they call it, the ice stuff or whatever, creating the fog, which looks really cool. So that'll be it for the Zedd figure. And next up, of course, we got my favorite character, Tommy, in the Green Ranger outfit here. So let's take a look at him. So there we've got the Green Ranger helmet with the Dragon Zord helmet going on there, the classic Dragon Zord looking helmet of the green. So you can see the mouth there. It's got the little diamond there on its like center of its head. I want to say nose, but the nose is down here, so it's more center of head. Then it's got this head fin and the eyes you can see there. Then going down, we've got the chest plate, which looks really nice, and I like all the little details with the Dragon Zord, or Dragon, little like symbol, I guess you call it there, the thing similar to in the back and stuff, but it's a nice armor piece. It looks really nice. They do really good detail in like designing and molding these characters. Again, like Jason was the Red Ranger in the first one, it is in that same mode that, again, talking about with the Dragon Ball Z characters and stuff. But underneath, you can see he's got the normal Power Ranger costume just in the green. You can see the white diamonds and everything going on in there. But in green, instead, he's got the Morpher. He's got the Dragon Dagger there on his side, so that's cool, instead of the Blade Blaster. But you can see on his arms, he does have also these gold like armbands and stuff. Again, they're supposed to be part of his armor that protect him. I don't know what they're supposed to do on his forearms, but they're there. And you can see he's got a little bit different design with the triangles instead of diamonds there on his gloves, and then the gold surrounding the tip of them. Same with the boots there, the gold at the end of it, and then the green diamonds into the white boots and stuff, and it looks super cool. Then in the background, we've got, so again, the bottom just green with lightning and stuff there, continued on into the back, but this time we got the dragon logo there, and it looks like, you know, the foot of the dragon or something there with the spikes or the claws on the end of it, and it looks just kind of like a plant leaf or something, but it's supposed to be, you know, like a footprint or something, like a Godzilla footprint, which looks pretty cool. So that is going to be it for the Green Ranger. And our last figure from this is the Megazord, which I think is really cool. Definitely one of my favorites. So let's take a look at here. So up top there, we've got the face of the Megazord. And of course, going through with how the Megazord is designed, built, it's from the T-Rex head that we've got going on there. So that's part of T-Rex that folds out, and then its whole upper body here is the T-Rex center body there. We do have the pterodactyl chest plate here. Again, that's where the rangers sit inside the Megazord stuff, and that's their viewing window and stuff there, and that's the pterodactyl. Then we've got the mastodon arms, like you can see with the black and the yellow and everything, that fold out from the mastodon. Then in the back, you can even see the guns that come off the mastodon and the T-Rex tail and stuff back in there as well. And then that feeds down into the feet, which we've got the saber-tooth tiger leg, yellow leg here, and the triceratops blue leg. Again, look really cool. I like the detail and design they did into it. It's still in the same pose pretty much as the what I call the Dragon Ball Z pose and stuff that the other rangers were in. But it's a little bit different because it's got a sword, at least. And this is what I was talking about. The sword can actually come out, and so you can take it out of its hand and everything, and so it's got the blade there. I forget what they call the blade, the sword. I can't remember. I think it's just like a mega sword. I don't know. I don't know if it even has a name, but I feel it does, but I can't remember at the moment. But it looks really cool. And again, on the background here, we've got the ground that's got the lava breaking through. Again, kind of how you see the dinosaurs coming out when they're forming into the Megazord. They come through ground and lava and stuff. It looks pretty cool. And then in the background, we've got some blue sky with lightning. And then we've got the lightning bolt for the Power Rangers logo there in the background, which looks really cool. And overall, looks really nice, like with that yellow and blue in the background and then the red up top here and stuff. It just looks super nice. And this one definitely sticks out and pops the most, and it's pretty dang cool, and so that is awesome. So that is going to be it for these Tamashii Buddy figures of the Power Rangers. Again, I don't know if they make any more than this. I guess I should probably look online to see if they do, and if they do, I need to order them or something. But once again, I'm just doing the review because I've kind of given up on waiting on them making the other Rangers, because like I said, I was only able to find these at Toys R Us, and now that Toys R Us isn't around anymore, don't really, besides possibly online, like I said, I don't have anywhere to get them. So I've been holding on these for at least 2 years now and decided to finally just do the review on them. So, and I really like these. I think they're cool. They're going to be really nice display figures. As you can see here, I think this looks super nice and cool and everything, the way they look, again, with the Ranger and then the power coins in the backgrounds and stuff. It just looks super nice, and they're really nice looking figures and everything. So that is going to be it for this review, again, of these Tamashii Buddy Power Ranger figures. So I hope you enjoyed. If you did, let me know in the comments down below. Don't forget to leave a thumbs up and subscribe to see more videos from my Morphin collection, showing off all my Power Ranger collection. But I want to thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.